Hello, everybody. What's a happenin'? Tonight we are going to do a little tube rolling in the AESTHETIX Romulus. You can see it right there. We're looking at the top, the black one. It has some 12 AX7s in there, some 12, I believe the second stage is a 12 AU, the earlier stage. I'll find out in a sec, but we're going to only play with the first stage first, then we'll go move to the next one. So this is the 12 AX is like the output or the line driver stage, if you will. It's the high gain type, which is first, there's one before it, and then this is the secondary stage right before the outputs. So we're starting with some Teslovac tubes, which are unique. I'm not really familiar with that brand or what have you. I know JJ Tesla, but that's not this, something else. I'll show you after I pull them out and I get the new ones in. So I've got a myriad of different tubes. I'll just, to kind of just really prove the point, instead of going through, like, you know, I mean, seriously, we could try like 15 different pair that I have of all different types. But rather than just do that, what I'm going to try and do and just try and pick some that are really far on one end, really far on the other end, so that people that have not heard tube rolling can really hear the, you know, what it sounds like and get a good make it easy for you guys to hear as easy as I can. So because these are E88cc, let's see if I can, I'll see what I can find up the ladder in that realm, 12AX, and so give me a second here while we'll just back this out. Let's see, go like this, okay. And we're listening again to the AESTHETIX Romulus, which is over here. We're going to be playing through from my server, which you can't see, but it's back there. It's my home build server to DAC. Out of the DAC to the crossover, which is right here, Marchand, four-way. And then out of the four-way, we're going to go one way to the sub here with a plate amp back there. Two and three is woofer and mid-range. And then four is the AGD Andante, or I mean Vivace, which goes to the hole that's 6 foot long tweeter out there, over there. And these are the subs. They're powered by a plate. The Jeff Roland is a two channel 625S2 is going to do the woofer and the mid. Okay, so here we go.
Like you're crying at the final breath that is drawn. Remember the love when I'm reborn. Is a strike to your shine in glorious thorn.
Okay, so I'm going to go swap out these tubes, get something else. Hold on. Okay, so here's a... Let me show you some of the stash. I don't know if you can see all that in there. Whoa, box full of tubes. There, we've got Telefunkies. We've got Amperexes. Let's see how I am. Okay, get Amperexes. All sorts of stuff in here. I'm going to pull them all out. And then we've got this right channel. See if you can see this. Hopefully they won't all come flying out. But so all these puppies too, man. And there's some good ones in there, baby. I'm telling you. So let me see if I can find some good ones. And we'll put them in. So hold on. Oh man, it's been a second since I've gone and looked at these tubes, but look what I got, man. You're not gonna believe it. Can you see? Let's see, where's the damn CCA, baby? It's a Siemens CCA gold pin. Just came across that puppy. Whoops. Here we go. That's a beauty. NOS. Doesn't look used. Let's see what else I can find in this.
Here's probably the most rare thing that is in here that I have, probably. Look at that. Oops, let's get a, come on now. AEG, CCA. These are definitely never used. Oops. AEG, CCA, gold pins, man. Doggy. Come on now. There we go. Beauty. Incredible. Let's see what else I got. Well, I wanted to do a few. This stash was actually mainly 6922 type, but here's what we've got. Let me get over here so I can make sure that we get focus on this. Okay. So we've got right here, we've got the Ico by Mullard, ECC83, which is a 12AXM. Now that's a hair right there. Yeah, that's not a crack. Okay, so here we are, the Ico by Mullard, ECC83. So those look pretty good. You check those out. I don't know how many, but I've got four pairs. So that one will probably be more bassy. If it's from Mullard, it's going to have bottom end, be a little more fuller. I've got some Valvo. They're from Holland, ECC83s. Nice. Little dudes there. And then let's see, I've got... is this one? Ooh, yeah, that's right. Let's see. Tung saw. Right, Chia. We've got some tung saw. Made in USA. Is that what it says? Yep. So I should probably say 12A7. What is it? What do we got here? What? Come on now. Retail 57. Oh, yeah. These are 5751s. So these are military low gain versions. So these should be nice and have lower noise, and I've got enough room on the preamp. You can see the volume's way to the left, so I've got enough room if they need a little more oomph. I can juice them up from the preamp, so we can use a lower gain tube on the output. It'll be all right. It's pretty close to the deck. Doesn't have to drive the line very far. Here's some interesting ones. These are ECC83s. They're marked ITT Lorenz. Get closer here. ITT Lorenz. So they must be used for some sort of computers or something like that. But what's interesting is, look at that one, is it looks the same and it's in the same bundle, so it should be CV492. So I'm not familiar with that and I can't find it quickly, so I'm sure it's good because they look identical and they were in the same package. So yeah, I'll check that out first online before I just go throw those in, just to make sure CV492 is okay. Okay, let's start with the tung sole 5751s, and let's see how those go. Now, I'm not going to change the volume at all. We're just going to see, and you'll hear how much less gain they have, so it'll probably be quieter right off the cuff, but then I'll turn it up. Okay, and we'll see if the sound quality's better. Hold on. Okay, so here's, I told you I'd show you the ones that were in there. Let me get up here. Here we are. Teslovak E83 CCS. S means it's matched triodes. Made in Slovakia. They look pretty sweet, man. I'll bet you these are pretty good tubes, but I just don't recognize them. I'm not familiar with what they are. I mean, I know what the type of tube they are. I just don't know what years they were made and all that. So if anybody knows about these things, Teslovak, please shed some light on it for us. They're pretty cool looking. They sounded good. I thought so. So let's see. And you know, we kind of want to give them a little time to warm up, don't we? Isn't that the deal? Got to give them a few minutes to warm up. Okay, so I'm going to do something else. I'm going to give them 10 minutes. I'll be right back. Okay, so here we go with the 5751s. It's a little bit softer, but... I think it's still the okay volume, but anyways, check it out. I mean, it's like completely different. But I'm singing like the barbarian now. The lights on the bar, but never before. Like you're crying at the fire. Breath that is drawn.
Okay, so I can tell you right off the cuff, definitely quieter. The bass was tighter and more it was tighter, more round. The spatiality was greatly enhanced or greatly showcased. I could hear the trails off the end of the vocals and the little sticks and everything. The decay was much greater on these. They had a much greater decay. You could hear stuff fade out really just nice and slow. The clarity was better. The vocal, he popped better from the background, and it just had more, it was more real. It had better realism for sure. Soundstage was about the same size, but it was much more lucid. Could really, 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 really see into that. That was something else. So now I'm going to take those out. Those are the 5751s, and let's put in these, let's see, let's try the Ico, the Mullard things, see how what those are all about. Hold on. But I'm singing like a barbarian man. The lights on the bar, but never before. Like you're crying at the final breath that is drawn. Remember me, love, when I. Is a shrike to your shine in glorious sweat. Okay, so definitely had like fuller bass, and then it had like this bass fill throughout. There's just like kind of a fill thing throughout the whole deal that actually crept up all the way up to the mids and almost slightly veiled them, which meant that the vocals were laid back and with that bass kind of fill. And then the very top was not quite as there. So it did not feel as lucid as the previous. It felt a little bit more dark, a little bit more smooth, and a little bit more dark. Actually, the other one was pretty smooth too. I wouldn't say that. So I'd say it's darker than the first one we tried. And it did have a lot of that low frequency that kind of sort of crept up and gave this little sort of like haze over things a little bit. That little tick-a-tick thing that you hear, you know, that's in there on the previous, like the first tubes, the Teslovac or whatever, you really got a, you could really hear those. It sounded like little sticks almost, like chopsticks or some sort of stick. But then with this one, without that real leading edge, it could have been, it's almost like more like a stapler or something, you know? It didn't sound like a stick. It sounded like something else. So that was kind of interesting. Very much so. Okay, so I'm going to go pull the Mullards out. We're going to put the Valvo ECC83s in from Holland and see what these are like. Okay, so hold on. Okay, now we've got the Valvos. I thought they were Holland, but they may be like Germany or Switzerland or something. I can't remember on Valvo. But here we go.
Like you're crying at the final breath.
Okay, so that one, the vocal came back in front of, okay, so that bass, that kind of little droning low frequency that was on the previous tube, disappeared with this one. It's still there, but it was at a lower level, so the vocal came in front of it. Whereby the last one, that drony kind of bass was in front of the vocal. Now, because it was trimmed back, it went behind the vocal. The vocal was clearly in front of it. So it gave us a little bit better realism than the last tube, for sure. Let's see. And the top on this seemed much more clean and more extending. I guess there's not that much material that we really heard that on. You hear it right at the beginning when he says something with shh, you know, and you hear that. But all in all, those sounded great as well. They're like hypnotizing me. I'm getting all like all sleepy and shit. So so I'm gonna try these next. Are gonna be these ITT Lorenz. Quickly see if CV492 is gonna blow me up or what. But should be all right. Okay, hold on. Okay, so now here we go with the ITT versions. Okay, so these ones I think had the best vocal. The vocal really came through nice and solid on these. The bass was like nice and balanced because it didn't stand out. In fact, it didn't draw its attention to me. Whereas on the first couple, the bass definitely drew its attention to me. You know, I noticed it because it was strong. While these have very clean top. You can really, the vocal's nice, and it pops well. Seems like a person's there more than any of the other ones. This one sounds most like there's a person right over there. So this, I'm sure I could give some volume to it, and it would you'd hear it get probably be good with volume. It wouldn't hurt your ears, you know. It'd be nice, and the vocal would be very prominent. I guess we can try that. I gotta find the remote, but let's try that. Okay, hold on. Okay, let's see if I was right about being able to turn it up a bit. Let's see. Thank you. Okay, so that's pretty killer, man. I mean, see right there, you can really see how the new old stock tubes can greatly influence your sonic. I mean, honestly, they make or break the piece. It can either sound not great or it can sound absolutely phenomenal, depending on the tubes. And for the good ones, you're going to spend probably $100 a tube, maybe $150. They're coming up in price, that boy, I'll tell you. They're not like they used to be. They came up in the last couple of years. They've gone up really quick. So now it's time for the secondary section. Let's see what I can dig up. So hold on. Okay, so what we had in the back section, the first section, are some Amprex 6DJ8s. All right, Sean. Let's see, where are you? Come on. 6DJ8, made in Holland. ECC88. So, that's what they look like. These ones have the standard pins. What I put in there is just, I just went straight for the CCAs. We're going to throw in, these are Siemens CCA. Made, and they've got the gold pins and everything. So these should be the best of the bunch anyways. That are a pair of 7308s as well. But let us, we'll just try these. See where they get us. Give me a little bit. Let me warm them up for a bit. Oh my God. Yeah, this is quite significant, this change. This is what I mean by make or break. So you can get one of these Pandoras. I mean, look, these things used, the used market, you can find them for like, and mine's a base model. You know, it's not the Eclipse or any of that crap. It's just like the base model. But man, listen to what it sounds like with this tube that I just put in. Now it's a pair now. There's two in the back, two in the front of highfalutin tubes. But I mean, it completely changed the character of this stack. From the first time we tried it, try go from the first number of the time code and then go to this last one here, and it's going to be such a big difference. It's crazy how much the tubes can change it. But so check this out. Here we go. And again, I haven't touched any volume. Oh, yeah. No, I did. I touched the volume when I brought that last one up to see how it sounded with a little bit more volume. That's okay. We'll leave it right where it is. But remember, so compared to all the others... Shit, I don't know exactly where it was. Well, let's see. So I'm going to turn it back down. Yep, I'm going to turn it back down. I think I went like one, I think it was like that. Now it won't be because I just heard it and it was like, oh my God. But now listen to it. You can still hear the image and everything. It's completely different. Here we go. Here. Like you're crying at the final breath that is drawn. Remember the love when I'm reborn. Is it shrink to your shine in glorious thorn?
Can't
Okay, so that was that. Just wanted to take a little second to show you guys tube rolling for those that have not experienced that, so you could see the difference. And now the tubes that I just changed at the back there, the back section, I have, let's see, I've got sitting right here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I've got 13 pairs sitting here, and that's just from the little cardboard box. I have not even opened that plastic, like, tackle box thing. I haven't even started with those. So I've got a lot of different ones. They're all very similar, but they have nuance to them, which makes them very different, especially in a rig that's very sensitive. So that was tube rolling. Hope you enjoyed it, and see you!